for me as a kid growing up listening to bands, you know, as Dan said, it's like a good man of none. That get me getting an album as a kid was important. Spending that money, spending that time, the first time I was ever had it as a kid. Bought an album and that.
Yeah.
Right? It's like, for me, it's like so important that the band that I'm buying the album, you know, the big crush on it, like, you know what I mean? It's like, you aren't going to be a rock band to rock. Do you know what I'm trying to say?
Yeah, yeah.
Like, you know, I went to many a reggae concert and it's rocked. Yeah. And many a punk rock concert and it's been rocking, you know. So that's what it is, like Dan said, it's like getting back to basics and basics as a musician, playing his instrument and performing at a club. Whether it's in a massive festival or a little shit or a club, you know, a little, you know. The most important thing is that fans will have to go out there and they have to step up the game, like you said, they have to.
I mean, that was where it came
laid
from.
Back to
yeah,
other.
And we just like happened, really. I think like
it was funny because that was one of the first things you called it epic, obviously. Didn't
yeah,
you?
Yeah.
And he had this he said, look, I got this piece of music that I wanted to try to come up with some ideas for, and we were touring with Flogging Molly in Germany, and I sat there and given him music, and this is like one of the first times where. We spoke about the lyrics and like spoke about before it was like, no, it fucking goes like this, nobody gets all that, that's the way it goes, and that's the way I was like, you know.
Yeah.
Because through time, you know, talking and reasoning and sitting down, bless you know, just through time and getting it, you know, you learn to just shut your mouth and listen to what someone else got to say.
Yeah.
And we sat down and we discussed the lyrics and where it should go and what kind of stuff, and I came up with a few different ideas. And it's like we discussed about, you know, where it should go, I tried some ideas and he went, you know, just sing, man, just sing your reggae thing, do what you do.
Because the idea, it was meant to be kind of like sort of trippy, kind of like, I wouldn't say trip-hop, you know, that kind of thing, you know, he just wanted to make it sound really vast, you know, really layers and everything.
Yeah.
And said to Ben, you know, just sing like a lover's rock tune on it.
Yeah.
You know? And he was like, at first you were like, and then you could hear
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah, I couldn't hear it first of all.
Yeah.
I was like, fuck man, it's like making me want to go, we are the original grand round, yeah. You know,
yeah.
It's like, no, go the wrong way with it. sing your heart out. Sing, like they used to say in the song, on the sound system, sing out your golden voice, please. Sing out your golden voice.
Yeah.
So I thought about it. Lyrically, I like, you know, like I just wanted, like, in the lyrics of Skindred, you know, people say to me, you know, you always sing about, like, you know, people and unity, you know, and this kind of stuff. I said, well, yeah, because that's what I want to see. That's the vision I have on every record. And
yeah.
I'll stop singing about it, you know, when it's there.
Yeah.
Sing about something else then.
Yeah.
Things like, you know, I speak to a lot of young bands all over the world, and they might not be, like, excellent, but it's fucking horrible when people come along and just crush them.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I don't know what you do, like, you know, certain this thing, but you want to be given a chance. So it was like, it wasn't like, some people think, oh, it's about journalism, it was journalism, it's just about, you know, those who, like, destroy your shit, but it's not even a seed, man, and you've been persuaded, give it a chance to, like, blossom a little bit, man. And that's what that song's about. It's just telling people, just ease off a little bit, but who would you tell them, like, you know, and even me, so it's not, I'm not saying I'm wrong, but even me talking to me as well, if I should do that.
Yeah.
I just want them. A lot of people have written to me like 3,000 and said that, like, you know, they've been encouraged by my friend, that they've been going through a similar type of thing.
Mm.
You know, I just believe that, you know, I want to give people something to encourage them through the darknesses of their life. No matter, it's not even the darkness of the world. Like, it's like, if you're going through hell, basically, just keep on going, because you're going to come out the other side and things should get better, you know?
Yeah.
And that's what the vibe of that song is about.